I'm Robert Nicholl from NC Engineering. I'm one of the directors here. Our company mainly manufactures agricultural, construction and commercial vehicles. We have markets throughout the UK and Ireland and Europe and the rest of the world. Innovation and R&D have been a major part of our business and helping us to expand our existing market and to invest in new technologies, new markets and new equipment. We have invested heavily and we have looked at automating quite a lot of our existing machinery. For example, we have a CNC lathes with C and Y axis for automatic turning of parts. We have recently installed a laser with a tower for automatic running and lights out. But one of our big investments has been our robotic welding cell. We reached out to Invest NI to help us to make the project possible. It's a large capital investment for a company of our size, and we were skeptical that it could be done, but with the help of Invest, they made it possible for us to find the right solution. We started looking into automation due to shortage of skills and lack of skills. Looking at the robot installation, it wasn't to try and replace employees, it was to try and better utilize the employees that we have. So we have guys who were welder fitters who are upskilled and are now programming the robot and operating the robot. They're involved in jig design and testing of products. They're now more involved in the design of new products to make it suitable for the robot. The big benefit is the productivity. The robot, if everything's in place, the robot welds all day, every day. There's no breaks. The consistency, the welds are exactly the same every time. By putting the robot in and letting it run, we save approximately 3 fabricator welders who can be better utilized to do jobs that are not suitable for the robot. So with the implementation of the robot, of course there's always skepticism by everyone. So our welder fabricators on the floor looked at the robot as competition, going, they're putting in robots, they're going to get rid of all the rest of us. Well, this has never been the case. The robot's there to make their life easier, to better utilize their skills in the jobs that the robot can't do, and take the melodic, monotonous tasks off them and put it to the robot. The perception of the robotic welding is that it does it perfectly every time, but for it to do it perfectly every time, all the parameters have to be met, and there's a lot of variations and variables with the robotic welding cells. So one of the big challenges was finding the sweet spot, so to say, of the weld and changing the amp, the burn back, the wire speed, the feed, the position of the welding head. Everything had its challenges and everything can be overcome, but in some instances it takes considerable time. The roadmap to deployment for us was a massive learning curve going from a traditional welding sense to robotic welding. There was a lot more complication in the parts, and I think we underestimated just how long it would take to bring into production. Managing the process and installation was done in-house. From our point of view, we find it better because there's no one knows our system or our facilities better than we do. With the deployment of the technology of the robot welding cell, we had a lot of support from the supplier. They are one of the world leaders in this type of robotic system. So their experience was drawn on heavily by ourselves. Future business strategy will be more robots coming into the system. Robotics is definitely the way forward for, as I said, taking the mundane parts of welding out of the operators and putting it to the robot, so that more skilled, highly skilled jobs can be done, the tacking, the jigging, the sorting of parts, and let the robot do the mundane tasks of welding. 3 tips for robotics and automation. It's find the right solution is the key. Do your due diligence, see the system, speak to the people, see applications on the ground, see if they look the same or can be applied to the same products that you are doing, and be patient.